Just like every other investor, bank, financial institution, or organization, World Economic Forum is also a fan of XRP. It has always supported XRP and even named XRP as the best cryptocurrency for the central bank's digital currency. The world is moving toward digitalization, and we knew that XRP is going to lead it. Now the World Economic Forum has already spoken about this in favor of XRP. In today's video, you will know about the recent secret message from XRP that signals toward the mass adoption of XRP and how it will lead to the sustainable future of payments. You will also know about the lawsuit and how it could establish limit on agencies' future involvement in crypto regulation. But before we get to the video, welcome back everyone to Crypto Millionaires, a channel where you get your daily dose of XRP. If you like the content, do give it a thumbs up. And if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so you don't miss any new video. As you know that we have announced a giveaway of 1,000 XRP coins, and there is a little delay in the announcement of the winner. So just hang on a little more, we will have our winner soon. Now, let's get to the video. We have been telling you in our previous videos that the world is stepping into a digital world and how crypto, and especially XRP, is going to play its role. Ripple XRP will be the new financial system of the world. Previously, the World Economic Forum has called XRP as the most relevant cryptocurrency for CBDCs. The World Economic Forum, or WEF, reports that central banks and government agencies are considering the potential of CBDCs to address long-standing global financial concerns. Ripple says that central banks around the space are locked in an arms race to develop their own CBDCs. The payment startup highlights that by ensuring a level of interoperability, central banks can leverage XRP to support and facilitate the use of CBDCs. This was said exactly a year ago. According to Ripple, interoperability will determine CBDC winners and losers, with the pandemic also encouraging the use of touchless payments instead of cash. It's no surprise to see central banks around the world racing to cement their perspective on the issuance of central bank digital currencies, or CBDCs. Governments that once viewed digital assets as a threat now see how companies like Ripple are working closely with traditional financial institutions to develop efficient, innovative global payment solutions that directly benefit businesses and individuals. CBDCs are now a question of when, not if, as the digital asset business has finally matured. While COVID-19 has prompted specific reasons for increasing mainstream acceptance and understanding of digital assets benefits, the long-term outlook for CBDCs includes broader economic benefits such as more efficient payment systems, greater financial inclusion, and increased scope for innovation. Now, just keep that in mind, and let's move to what the World Economic Forum has said recently. WEF shared that, and Candy B says, to enable trade with more digitization, you need interoperability of systems. That includes payment systems, quality standards, and the way the goods move between one country and another. This was said in the World Economic Forum's Sustainable Development Impact Summit. Ankiti says that interoperability of payments leads to traceability, which leads to sustainability. They need more favorable technology for this. Let's have a look at what Ankiti said in the conference.
Thing that enables trade to happen very quickly with more digitization is interoperability of systems. And that includes interoperability of payment systems, of quality standards, of the way that goods move between one country and another, and in several supply chains, like the textile supply chain.
Now, what they are talking about is the blockchain. It is the new and complete technology for all their problems. Specifically, Ripple XRP, it is faster, less costly, more scalable than any other digital asset, and the most important these days, the sustainability. What crypto asset is the most sustainable? That's XRP. This makes XRP the most suitable currency for the new digitized financial system of the world. The World Economic Forum also has a list of digital assets, among which RP is the top one. In its recent published community paper, the Swiss-based International Organization for Public-Private Corporation also listed XRP and its global open-source blockchain, the XRP Ledger, or XRPL. According to the paper, XRP boasts 1,500 transactions per second, costs 0.0003 cents per transaction, and settles in 3 seconds. XRP was the only coin on the list with such numbers of transactions. The world is becoming increasingly digital. XRP will be the world's new financial system. XRP will serve as a bridging currency for CBDCs, as we already know. We also have proof that the IMF will issue SDRs in XRP. Fiat currencies are gradually being phased out of the game. According to a Deloitte survey, cryptocurrencies will be a viable alternative to traditional fiat currencies. Digital assets will be a feasible alternative or adequate substitutes for traditional fiat currencies in the next 5 to 10 years, according to the survey. Another important indicator that the world will be paying greater attention to crypto money in the future is the fact that Congress has already introduced 18 bills this year. This shows that how much the government is giving time to the digital assets because they know what the future holds. The Ripple SEC lawsuit has helped XRP gain the recognition. A seemingly esoteric legal battle involving the Securities and Exchange Commission and fintech startup Ripple Labs could provide clarity on how much authority the SEC has over regulating the $2.2 trillion crypto market. The SEC filed a complaint against Ripple Labs, a worldwide payment platform, in December of 2020, saying that the company had violated securities regulations by neglecting to register its XRP coin as a security. After Joe Biden's triumph over Donald Trump in the 2020 presidential election, the SEC chair, Jay Clayton, made one of his final moves before leaving office. The SEC claimed that at the time, Ripple was utilizing XRP to fund its main business of smooth cross-border transactions for financial institutions, which it had been doing for 7 years since its establishment in 2013. The SEC argues that Ripple is different because XRP was actively used to fund Ripple's business and essentially represents an investment in the company itself. Thus, it constitutes security, not a commodity, and falls under the SEC's regulatory purview under court precedent known as the Howey test. The current situation of the market and how the lawsuit has affected XRP is making the value of the coin to go down. The experts are of the view that value will go further down before rising up bullishly. XRP price set up a swing high on August 15th and breached this local top to create a new one on September 6th. However, the second attempt failed as the market experienced massive selling pressure the next day. Now Ripple is continuing to head lower with no signs of recovery. XRP price was on a roll as it rallied from 95 cents to $1.35 between August 13th and August 15th. This run-up brought the uncertain and hesitant investors out of the woodwork as Ripple crashed 18% to $1 over the following weeks. According to the FX Street, the greedy buyers pushed XRP price to set up a swing high at $1.41, well above the August 15 swing high at $1.35. While traders continued to leverage long XRP, the Relative Strength Index, or RSI, was forming a lower low during the August 15th and September 6 peaks, resulting in a bearish divergence. This is perhaps one of the most important reasons why XRP's price, while this event coincides with El Salvador's airdropping $30 worth of BTC to each of its citizens who downloaded a state-sanctioned wallet, the technical aspects were hitting at the overextended nature of the uptrend and suggested a crash was on its way. The number of daily active addresses peaked at around 31,316 by the end of the first week of September. As XRP continues to decline, so does the number of investors interacting with the Ripple blockchain. On September 17th, the metric created a low high at 28,761, representing an 8.15% decline over the course of 11 days. This decrease indicates that the market participants are uninterested in the prospects of XRP price right now and are likely converting or selling their holdings, leading to a downtrend. According to the CoinMarketCap, at the time of writing, the XRP price today is 90 cents USD, with a 24-hour trading volume of $4.4 billion USD. XRP is down 0.54% in the last 24 hours. The current CoinMarketCap ranking is number 6, with a live market cap of $42 billion USD. It is a circulating supply of 46.6 billion XRP coins and a max supply of 100 billion XRP coins. So guys, this is it for today's video. I hope it could be a big help to you. What do you think the economic forum will use XRP? How long will XRP face the dump? Share your views in the comments down below. Don't forget to click the bell icon, and thanks for watching.